These are the features of the Standard & Poor's 500, the E-mini Standard & Poor's. As we can see, the target or break of breaker reverse or reversal in the zone of 1432 couldn't be confirmed as a breakout to the upside, but either way we could achieve the 1441 zone. Actually, this was the main target zone of 1450. We speculated last week that if we could break to the upside in 1450, we were going to look for the 1500 mark. When we had this reversal on this day, the day that tried to make a break for it on the break or reversal target, we got this intraday reversal. We could expect a downward movement in the next coming days. This was what happened, and as we can see, the failure to support the sell pressure on 1400 gave room to a strong reversal of a very strong correction that lasted almost every single day of last week. As we can see, it's possible that we are in a next wave. We were in a next wave, and now we are resuming the downtrend. But for now, we have to take advantage of the Elliott count and don't make jump for it and try to ride the bear market. And this could be a big mistake, since in this zone we are still in a movement that could be only a counter trend movement inside a major counter trend. So this could be a counter trend movement in the long term, but this could be this last 5 days could be a counter trend inside the counter trend. So at least we approached the main target in 1,395, and we crossed the secondary target in 1,381. But if we don't cross this resistance that we have over here, we are still in an uptrend, and we are only seeing a correction inside the downtrend. If we cross 1364 approximately in the next few days, and we look for the 1350 mark, yes, in that scenario, we are bound to think that we are in a major reversal again and continuing the bear market. But as we wait in this level, we have to be very sure of what we do, because if this resistance line holds the sell pressure, we are going for a 61% probability of a new high. If this market supports next week the zone of 1364, and we can move across 1400 to the upside again, we have a 61% of a new high. If this scenario is correct, we are going to look for 1500. That could be a critical mistake if we gain confidence in this as a continuation of the bear market and try to trade it. So we have to wait for this trend line if it holds or not. If we see the weekly chart, we can speculate, as we did earlier last week, that this could be an A wave and this an ABC, a complete ABC, and this could be a next wave and opening the ground to a new ABC that emulate the movement from the zone of 1590 to 1250. It could be a major crash, but at the same time, we have this last week was a severe reversion, but we could speculate that this could be only a correction. So we have to be pretty sure that this is a resume of the downtrend. Everything seems to indicate that this is the case. We are in a resume of the downtrend, and the main target could be 1250, but as we see the daily chart, we have this target that still can be a counter trend to resume the medium term, the midterm uptrend to continue to new high. So we have to be pretty sure of what we do, and to resume the vision of an extreme bear market, we could expect to the 1350 level. If we don't expect this level, and this level fails to be break to the downside, we could be trapped in a major reversal to the upside again. So as the market is extremely choppy and trendless in the long term, we can expect to make a break for it in the 1350. If we break this level, we are going to fail hard. But the responsible traders should wait for a 1350 breakout or step away and wait for it before taking down trades. Looking to the ETF of the Standard & Poor's, the SPY, as we can see, the uptrend line, the downtrend line, the resistance dynamic line that allowed this last up movement was back to the downside again. But as in the mini chart, we have that even if we fell to the 1367 level, at that level we'll still be able to speculate that this is only a counter trend movement. So we have to wait to be sure that this is a resume of the downtrend, since this could be not the case, and that could be a major mistake if we try to ride the bear market, and the bear market signal still is not quite the signal we should expect for. So as we can see, 1370 is a support good enough to support the sell pressure. So if we cross 1350 to the downside, we are extremely aware that the resume of the downturn will be a fact. But if this 1350 level is not broken to the downside, it's earlier to take bear market trades that could be catastrophical.